Hey guys and girls and all the rest, it's me, your boy, TR. And I'm back with another review video where I talk about your videos as a viewer on YouTube. And up first, we have Killick Da Truth. Try saying that 3 times fast. The video that I'm going to be looking at is this. It's a storytime animation where he talks about the time where he fell in love. Yeah, I can relate to that. So, how was the video? The video was overall good. The animation was nice and the pacing of the story was nice as well. It wasn't unnecessarily padded, nor did I get bored. However, there were multiple instances where I couldn't understand what you were saying. It sounded unclear, and you should try fixing that. One more thing that I can add is that you should try animating what you say more. An example of what I mean is, instead of saying, "I saw a dancing cow," while you're just doing this, you could try animating it. I'm not saying to animate the entire video, but animating the funny or noteworthy events in the story could have made the video more enjoyable. But yeah, that was me nitpicking. So TLDR, your video is good, just work on speaking clearly and to also animate key elements of your story. Also, get rid of that intro. It's not good. You could skip the intro entirely. Most big YouTubers don't have intros since they know people would just skip them. I actually looked at other videos on his channel as well. Well, looked as in I just looked at the thumbnails and saw that he is primarily a gaming channel. He has only made 3 animations and the rest of his videos are video game content. So why didn't I look at them instead? Well, I like stories and this was the only video that looked quite interesting. The other one was kinky and the third one was this. So I picked the heartbreak one.
Well, I mean, I guess I gotta start from the beginning, like 5 years ago. I was starting this new high school. And it's a magnet school because your boy's actually really smart if you ain't new. And I met this girl and I thought she was the most gorgeous, most beautiful girl I ever met in my entire life up until that point. And I immediately thought, I gotta have her.
The next video belongs to Vene Reality or Ven Reality. It's a Minecraft video and believe it or not, I have never played Minecraft before. So if I get something wrong, please don't crucify me in the comments. So, on to the video. It was just a bunch of friends goofing around in Minecraft. But, was it entertaining? Short answer, no. Long answer, no. I was bored and was just going to skip the video in its entirety. However, the only reason I chose this video was because it was short. So I decided to check out another video. Even though it's long, I decided to check it out because if I didn't, I would seem unfair. And I have to say, this was much better. The video is edited well, it had good commentary, and is overall much better than this one. If I do have to say something critical, then I'd ask you to get rid of this intro. I explained why earlier. But other than that, the video was nice and people who enjoy Minecraft content would be into this as well. Their other videos are about Minecraft as well. So if you like the game, go check it out.
Merch.
No, the emerald.
I got them.
Oh. Yellow is coming and they've got weapons. And I've got a fist that they just knocked me off.
Hey, I've got a fist too. My fist is the best weapon besides the
magic. I'll use mine.
The next video is from Gory Boys Animations, and that's boys with a Z. The video they submitted was a skit? Or a fight? Maybe pro wrestling. I honestly have no idea, but it was quite interesting to watch, and I liked it. It was funny. Well, most of the time. Both of the actors were funny, but my personal favorite was this guy. However, there were some issues with the audio, like in some instances where I couldn't hear what they were saying, but those happened sparingly. Maybe you could have recorded the audio separately though, that would have greatly increased the audio quality. But if that's not your style, you could have gotten a clip-on mic as well. It won't be perfect, but it will do the job well. A thing that actually bothered me personally was the sound effect you used for punching. It was kinda similar to a laugh track, as in it's too overused, but that's just me nitpicking again.
I gotta get into shape!
You are in a shape! You're in a circle!
What's that?
fat joke? My god.
But the interesting thing I found about this channel is that they don't solely produce these kind of skits, but instead they produce a variety of other interesting content as well. Like for instance, Taste and Talk, a short food review series, which are under 5 minutes. And yes, I usually don't check out other videos, but I think they really need some help. For one, a video usually less than 5 minutes does not need 30 seconds of introduction. Just skip it entirely. No one is going to complain in the comments about how the intro is so tiny. And two, what's with the old scaling? Change it. And three, 360p in 2020? Come on, dude. I mean, most of my videos are in 480p, but they're not of real life characters or people. If you want to record yourself, please record it in at least 720p. Oh, they also talk about My Little Pony merch. Not saying that's a bad thing, it's just not what I expected to see on this channel, especially after I saw this. Anyways, the next channel is Bumperdum682. And yes, I did have fun saying that name. The video is him playing Akinator. Pretty self-explanatory. However, there is another reason why I selected this video apart from me having a tiny attention span. I expected a twist. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, you can play games in a variety of ways, such as the straightforward path, like a game of Doom where your only objective there is to play as a guy who is literally too angry to die. But there is also the indirect way of playing where you can spin your own narrative and story, adding something that is unique and entirely your own. I expected this video to be the latter. However, the video was him narrating the entire gameplay session, which is not a bad way to do gameplay if you're doing something like an RPG. However, different kinds of games have to be presented in different styles. You can't really give a detailed commentary regarding the game when you're playing something like Tetris. I mean, I can't, but maybe you can. One of the things you could have done to make the video better is the viewer participate as well. What I mean is, instead of revealing what you want Akinator to guess, you could have asked the audience to guess as well by keeping the name a secret. That would actually make us, the audience, on our toes, and it would actually feel like we were participating as well. If you want a good example on how to make these kinds of videos entertaining, just check out Video Game Donkey playing Akinator.
In 3, 2, 1, you have been warned. Oh my- Out of all pictures.
The next video is from Lord Pyromon. It's a video where he talks about a Catwoman game for the GameCube. So, was it bad? Was it boring and dull and something that made me fall asleep? Well, no. Actually, subscribe to his channel because it was really, really good. The writing was good, what he said was good, the few moments of humor he added was also good. What he said about the topic was sensible and actually interesting without stretching the point nor making it boring. The video was well edited and the pacing was also really good. The only thing that I can say is the audio quality, but if I'm being honest, it didn't bother me that much. The channel should have more subs, so why doesn't it? It's probably due to him releasing videos sparingly, like one or two videos a month. Which I can't fault him for doing because mostly what he does is video game related and you can't just finish most video games in under an hour. And also doing real life things as well, I completely understand. But still, I would have wanted you to be more active on your channel, as in more videos per month.
Or is selling corrosive makeup and is promptly killed. She's okay though, because she's immediately resurrected by... cats! Because she's Catwoman. Okay. Patience then decides to don the identity of Catwoman after learning she now has all the powers and abilities of a cat, such as purring, cracking a whip, and having a crippling addiction to catnip.
And that is all the time that I have for now. If your video hasn't been reviewed, then don't worry. I'll talk about it in the next video. I got a lot of videos to talk about this week, so I have to split these two into multiple episodes. Otherwise, I'd have to make a really, really long video, which I really don't want to make. If you want me to review a video of yours, please put it down in the comments. I'll talk about it. eventually. And I hope you enjoy the video. And...
Arrivederci!